JoJo on the radio.
On 102.7 KIIS FM.
Panic at the Disco, fellas, how you doing?
Hey there.
Great. How are you?
You just put your shades on just like 2 seconds ago. Is it like a tradition to go on mic, even on radio with the shades
on? No, there's a guy with a camera in here, and he just turned on the light, and it's really bright.
Light sensitive.
Light sensitive eyes.
Yeah, especially when the new album's out, you gotta put the shades on to keep the paparazzi away from you.
Pretty odd. Go pick it up. You know what I mean?
All right, the first time I met you guys, so a dumb question. The name Panic at the Disco, why that, and what names did you guys bounce out before you settled on Panic at the Disco?
Well, when I joined the band, we were called the Summer League, and we played pop punk, and we were about 15, 16 years old. About 5 months after we were playing all that, we changed the name to Panic at the Disco, and it was from a band we were listening to at the time. They're called Name Taken, actually from Orange County, and they have a song called Panic, and in the song it says Panic at the Disco, and really had no meaning. We just thought it sounded weird, and we were just, you know, fans of the band, so why not?
Fans of weird.
Fans of weirdness.
Thus the name of the album, Pretty Odd, which, why the title Pretty Odd? You guys are just an odd bunch of guys, right?
Yeah, it kind of just describes how the album sounds, and even more on the lines of just the past 3 years of our lives, and the last record coming out, and pretty much all that's happened. And
we have a lot of Spinal Tap moments, you know, so.
So you turn it to 11, not 10?
Exactly.
If you guys haven't seen that movie, freaking look that thing up.
Classic.
Let's move into the actual live show. People have described you, at least a couple of my friends, have described you as one of the most, I guess, theatrical kind of bands as far as the performance. Sort of Moulin Rouge meets, you know, something they haven't seen before. Fair statement? Unfair? True? False?
Yeah, you know, we definitely like to do some theatrical stuff in our live shows. That was mainly, you know, to fit the last record. You know, there's a lot of crazy music on it and very fast-paced, so we tried to keep up with it and brought out performers and stuff. And, you know, we kind of did that, so this time around we're going to try something different. It's a little scaled down, but...
Yeah, we felt like that kind of whole vaudevillian circus type of feel really went along with the album. And we still have the same intention of doing that with this album, but, you know, just different ideas.
Different visuals.
The video for Nine in the Afternoon. This got sort of Beatles meets Clockwork Orange or something, right? Or that's kind of another venture into this, to the world of the weird as well, sort of, right?
Yeah,
the world of weird.
Yeah, you guys, that should be like the next album title.
Panic's World of Weird.
JoJo names it World of Weird. He gets no royalty to check it off. Hey, but what made you guys go down that road? Because you guys are walking down the street in this video, and some dude's wearing an elephant mask.
Yeah, that was going to be the first single, obviously, and we were coming up with the concept while we were still recording the album. We were talking about what we wanted to do. We didn't really have too much of an idea, and we've got some treatments, and none of them really impressed us. And then Shane, the guy who directed the first two videos of ours, the one for I Write Sins and the one for But It's Better If You Do, he sent us over a treatment, and he's just kind of got it.
Thanks, Shane Drake.
Thanks, Shane.
The track is called 9 in the Afternoon. Before I play it, you need to explain what this song is about, because I have no idea.
I don't know.
It means whatever you want it to mean.
I don't know. Panic at the Disco. 4 members in the band. I'm not sure what happened to the other 2, but I got 2 in front of me right now. Please introduce yourselves.
I'm Brendan.
And I am John.
Speed round of questions, dude. Total random. Answer any way you want to answer. Say pass if you don't want to answer. Here we go.
All right.
Panic at the Disco. Last
Vanilla.
Time. Perfect. Last time you guys got in trouble.
I left my underwear on the dryer, and that's a no-no at my house.
Today?
That was last week.
So you have them on now. Good.
Yes, thank God.
I got cut off on the airplane last night.
You did what?
I got cut off.
On the airplane.
I asked for another glass of wine, and they said, no more wine.
Were you toasted or something?
No. You're only allowed 2 drinks within an hour.
Oh, really?
And it was only
It was a 36-minute flight, and they gave us 2 glasses of red wine. So.
You know we're a rock band? We need alcohol.
We're in Coldplay?
I mean, dude. Ever had your heart broken?
Sure. Actually, I have a story about that. My dog ran away for 3 days.
What kind of dog?
It was an Italian toy greyhound. Her name's Dylan. She is insanely small and cute. And luckily, we found her again, but...
She was gone.
Home-cooked meal. When you go back home, what is the meal?
Crab legs.
Nice.
Cowboy goulash.
Where is home? Vegas, I assume?
He's from Vegas, and I'm from Chicago.
Embarrassing naked moment.
I don't know if it's embarrassing. I like being naked a lot, so...
All right.
I'm naked a lot of the time.
Autographs. When's a good time and a bad time to ask for an autograph in panic?
Bad time when we're eating, because we love food.
At a family party.
Good or bad? Good.
What if a family member asked for the autograph?
That's what I'm saying.
Exactly. Ever milked a cow?
No.
Believe in ghosts or UFOs?
Paranormal activity. I'm still convinced.
Alien cows.
I'm one of these dudes that I'm like junior Ghostbuster wannabe.
No.
I'm dying.
I was all about ghosts. I had the ectopack. I had the jumpsuit.
Amen, dude.
Come on, man.
I believe in the force.
Do you like cheese?
Cheese.
Love cheese.
One thing in your iPod people wouldn't expect?
Tupac.
Most cash in your hand at any one time?
I want 1,000. $1,000 off of our guitar player on a game of dice once.
I think we were in Australia and I was playing blackjack and I won $1,800. Australian, I don't know what that converts to, but that's it was
like
a lucky night.
That's like $30.
It's like three American dollars.
Most famous person in your BlackBerry, your sidekick, or trio. Don't include band members, obviously.
My dad.
You guys remember your first celebrity moment?
Yeah, Tom Cruise was over for cocktails one night at my house. And he actually invited Katie's
really?
And baby Suri.
Yeah.
Wow, how'd that go?
It was pretty interesting.
Were you cooking or did they?
No, Tom cooked. He brought a casserole over.
Cruise brings the casserole.
Cruise's casserole, that's what they call it.
You guys need help. Have you ever been poked in the eye?
I poked myself in the eye this morning. I'm serious, I did. I was going up to reach for something like my hair. I was like, ooh. It's weird that you bring that up because it still hurts kind of. It's like a little bit smaller than my left eye.
Which I see if your eye looks red.
Yeah.
Yeah? Looks all right.
Good? All right, good.
Final question. Have you ever cried in the movie theater Panic at the Disco?
Titanic.
Oh, dude. Who does
seen it?
Yes.
And Free Willy.
I cry a lot at movies.
Free Willy. The first Homeward Bound.
The first Free Willy? When Michael Jackson's song comes in.
Hold on, River
Panic at the Disco's here. You guys want to get the album, go to a thing called a store or download it somewhere. Album's called Pretty Odd.
Please go buy. We're running out of food.
Anything you guys want to say about the album or something or getting poked in the eye? Final thoughts to Los Angeles.
Yeah, we had a lot of fun doing it, and I think you'll have a lot of fun hearing it.
Hopefully.
All right, we're going to turn the mics off, and we're going to shoot a video that I'm going to put up online. KIIS FM.com, keyword JoJo. I have no idea what this video is going to have in it. It's sort of like potluck. You might like it, you might not.
I can fit inside of a suitcase.